Hello children, today we are going to continue with chapter 16, present tense. In this lesson already we learnt about one of the forms of present tense, that is simple present tense. Today we will be learning present continuous tense. Okay, present continuous tense. Now what am I doing? Can you say? I am teaching. Then, what are you doing? You must be listening to me. You are listening to me. Then, look at this picture. What is this girl doing? She is running. And what are they doing? They are playing. So children, here you can see the verb teaching, I'm teaching, you are listening to me, she is running, they are playing. All these actions are going on now, right now. Right now I am teaching you and you are listening to me right now. So she is running, they are playing. So all these verbs are expressed in present continuous tense because these actions are going on. So present continuous tense, mostly we use present continuous tense to express the actions which are going on at the time of speaking. So now let's see the structure of present continuous tense, how to form a sentence in present continuous tense. Here, subject plus is, am or are plus ing form of the verb. To make a sentence in present continuous tense, subject plus is, am or are plus ing form of the verb. So if the subject is singular, we use is, and with the subject I, we use am. With the plural subject, we use are. So look at the table given here. Here subject I is used, the auxiliary verb am is used with the subject. So I am working. Then with the subject you, we, they, here are is used. With the pronouns you, we, they and any other plural subject, are is to be used. So you are working or we are working, then they are working. Then if the subject is singular, the pronouns she, he or it, with these subjects is to be used. He is working, she is working or it is working. So to make a sentence in present continuous tense, subject plus either is, am or are plus ing form of the verb. Then now let's see the uses of present continuous tense. As I told, present continuous tense is used for an action going on, which is continuing, going on at the time of speaking. Now look at this picture. What is this girl doing? She is playing in the rain. So it is raining. You can see it is raining. That is raining right now. Then that girl is playing in the rain. Here you can see is plus ing form of the verb. With the verb, ing form is used. Then she is playing with the base form of the verb play. ING form is used because here the subject is singular. She is playing in the rain. Now it is used to denote temporary action which may not be actually happening at the time of speaking, but the action is continued near about the suitable time. At the time of speaking, that action may not be continuing. For example, these days I am revising my courses. Right now I am not revising my courses, but these days. So that is expressed in present continuous tense. Then I am working on an interesting project these days. Right now am I working on the project? No, but these days I am working on an interesting project. So that is expressed in present continuous tense. Then he is studying for his entrance exams. So that action is also right now, that action is not happening, but these days he is preparing for the entrance exam. So that is also expressed in present continuous tense. Now the present continuous tense is also used for a fixed program or plan of the nearest future, which may happen the nearest future. Such actions can be expressed in present continuous tense. For example, my uncle is going to Delhi tonight. That action of going will happen in the near future. So that's why it is expressed in present continuous tense. Then we are playing a friendly match next week, which is near future. That action of playing will happen in the near future. So that can also be expressed in present continuous tense. Now let's see how to form a negative sentence in present continuous tense and an interrogative sentence in present continuous tense. So to make a negative sentence, we just add subject plus either is, am, are plus not plus ing form of the verb. And to make an interrogative sentence, just to place the helping verb in the beginning, either is, am or are is to be placed in the beginning, then subject plus ing form of the verb, then question mark. For example, Shyama is reading the newspaper. So subject here, subject, then as the subject is singular, is used. Shyama is, just after is, negative word not is to be used. Shyama is not reading the newspaper. Then question, just to place is in the beginning, the helping verb is in the beginning. Is Shyama reading the newspaper? So you got an interrogative sentence. Now based on this, one exercise is given there. Identify the tense of the given sentences. First one, the college reopens in June. Here you can see, here the subject, the college, then here the base form is used, base form plus s is added here. So in which tense we use subject plus base form or s or is? In simple present tense. So the sentence is in simple present tense. Then he is repairing his computer. What is he doing? He is repairing. That action is going on. So the action which is going on is to be expressed in present continuous tense. So it is in present continuous tense. Here subject he, then is plus ing form is used. So the sentence is in present continuous tense. Then these girls learn music every day. These girls learn music every day. That's that action is repeating daily. It's a repeated action. So that such actions are to be expressed in simple present tense. So moreover, you can see the subject, these girls, then base form is used, subject and a base form. So the sentence is in simple present tense. Next one, Ajita does her work sincerely. Here which is the subject? Ajita. Then with the verb do, es is used. Subject plus base form plus es. So this sentence is in simple present tense. It's a fact, and Ajita does her work sincerely. It's a fact. So it is given in simple present tense. Now, how many teams are participating in the debate competition? It's an interrogative sentence. Now see, Which words are used here? Are participating. Here teams, that is the subject. So are subject plus are plus ing form. So it is given in present continuous tense. So children, today we learned how to form a sentence in present continuous tense and how to make negative sentence and in which situations we must use the present continuous tense. I hope it is clear. Thank you.